been in cars for a very long time. These days, it's rare that I see something that's truly new. Huh, that looks new. If you don't know, Rivian is an American electric vehicle startup, and their first production vehicle is this, the R1T pickup truck. And man, is it interesting. But first, cue the quadcopter footage. The R1T features an individual motor powering each wheel. Yes, math whizzes, that equals four motors. According to Rivian, it can tow up to 11,000 pounds, it rockets from 0 to 60 miles per hour in as quick as 3 seconds, depending on the surface, of course, and it'll cover 314 miles with the base 135 kilowatt hour battery pack, according to the EPA. A larger 180 kilowatt battery pack is in the pipeline for $10,000 that should deliver more than 400 miles of range. By the way, the company I work for, Cox Automotive, invested $350 million in Rivian. I've never met the investment people. I have no idea how any of that works, but now you know. Back on task, look at this interior. Intriguing textures, subtle splashes of color, open-pore ash wood trim, and these carabiner-inspired elements on the backseat pockets. There is a finesse here that feels drawn from beyond the automotive realm. Nothing feels cheap, there are no unsightly gaps, the cabin conveys quality from top to bottom. On that note, these floor mats are made of Chilliwitch, which you might recognize from Crate & Barrel's doormat selection. As for dimensions, the R1T competes among mid-sized trucks. Let's see how my 5'10 inch frame fits inside the Rivian R1T. Moving up to the front seat, let's get a comfortable driving position here, and it's not moving because it's not on, but I can assure you, I can get a very comfortable driving position. There's a good telescope on the steering wheel here, and the arm pad situation, this is squishy. My elbows, my glass-like elbows, will not complain. Oh, and one interesting thing too, look down here. This is the kind of thing you only see normally in a minivan, a big open space where you can put like a purse or something. That's really great functionality. I fit well up front. Let's see, I sit in the second row, and yeah, oh my gosh. Okay, I'm gonna move over a row so you can see how much headroom I have. Now, the legroom situation is not accurate because this seat is really far back. I can tell you that on the drive up here into the mountains from Denver yesterday, I had a ton of knee space, something in this range right here. Good foot space underneath. My only complaint would be a lack of static lumbar support on the rear seat back. I'd love a little bit more supports down low. So I might have to bust out my old man inflatable lumbar pillow. But besides that, this is a plenty roomy truck for family duty. Yeah, awesome.
Other clever interior bits include a flashlight built into the driver's door, this optional removable Bluetooth speaker that charges when stowed and doubles as a camp lantern, supplemental storage beneath the rear seats, a digital driver information screen, plus a separate 16-inch screen on infotainment duty. As a fan of Apple CarPlay and Android Auto smartphone integration, I'm dismayed there are no plans to offer either in the R1T. Thankfully, the R1T's infotainment layout is simple, logical, and welcoming. Of course, the R1T is a truck. We should talk about truck stuff.
How do you drop the tailgates? There's a button right here on top of the rail. Just push that and it comes down. And this little guy right here, this platform connects the tailgates with the bed. So you have this seamless flat platform. So if you're loading things in, it's really easy to do so. If you look on the top of the rails, you've got these little tie down points, and those also function. You've got a rail system that goes across. In fact, they have a version with a pop-up tent that's mounted on these, which is super cool. But in terms of ultimate coolness, check this out. There's a button over here, and then the power tonneau extends out. This is optional. On the base model, this is a manual tonneau cover, but that kind of locked safe space for all of your gear is super cool. Oh, and I should also mention that underneath the bed here, as that tonneau noise kicks back in, you pull a lever on this side, this pops up, and you have a full-size spare, which really comes in handy if you're going off-road. You thought I was done, but I'm not. There's also an air compressor over here, and then I'm gonna leap into the bed. And on this side, if you take a little peek down here, love, you've got two outlets so you can charge your gear. I'm more of a margarita machine guy, but make your own choices. A truly unique feature of the R1T is this, the gear tunnel. Push a button here, this opens up and you have 11 cubic feet of storage space that is secure and won't flop stuff around in the bed. Also, the door here doubles as a step so you can load stuff up on the roof or you can sit down and contemplate your place in the universe. What does it all mean, man?
By the way, the gear tunnel has a pass-through so you can grab items from inside the cabin. You can also fill it with the kitchen. Insert hackneyed everything plus the kitchen sink joke here. Seriously though, for $5,000, Rivian will install this slide-out camp kitchen, complete with a 30-piece cookware set, an inductive stove powered by the truck's battery pack, a 4-gallon water tank, and yeah, there is a sink.
Like many electric cars, the R1T has a frunk. And pro tip on how to open it, go to the center camera here and then slightly to the left, and there's the button, and then it powers right on up. The amount of space is good. This is another great secure space to put stuff. Although I will say that I like how the Ford F-150 Lightning, the grill comes up with it, so you have a low lift in. This you have to kind of lift up and over. Nonetheless, a useful space.
It's been a minute. Let's cram a few more drone shots into the edit. That is nice. And a convenient segue into how the Rivian R1T drives.
Let me guess, you'd like me to full throttle accelerate this thing from a stop. For you, anything. 3, 2, 1. Yeah. Laughing under hard acceleration is such a cliche, but sometimes you can't help it.
Prompt and relentless electric torque sure is cool. According to Rivian, the R1T's four motors cumulatively produce more than 800 horsepower and more than 900 pound-feet of torque. If the novelty of gut-punch acceleration ever dims, know that Rivian's truck is also a pleasure to drive at sensible speeds.
Leave the suspension in soft mode, and ride quality in the R1T is outstanding.
Key to that pleasing ride is an air suspension featuring adaptive dampers and an electro-hydraulic roll control system standing in for traditional anti-roll bars. In concert, the R1T's suspension can vary ground clearance from 7.9 inches to 14.4 inches while delivering a plush ride or, depending on the drive mode, keeping the chassis taut and oddly flat in corners. I mean odd as a compliment.
As you might expect, a lack of engine noise means you're more aware audibly of tire and wind noise, but I can attest to the fact that you can have a modest level conversation at freeway speeds just fine. Hey Lily, what's up?
Hello.
There is a person back there, I swear.
One area where electric vehicles often struggle is with unnatural feeling brakes.
In this case, regen is handled exclusively by coming off throttle. The brake pedal only actuates the hydraulic brakes. Consequently, it feels just like a normal brake pedal. Ah, it is so nice to drive an electric vehicle that slows as well as it goes.
Some nitpicky complaints include overly heavy steering efforts at higher speeds, at least according to my weak journalist arms. I also noted distracting reflections at some sun angles from the driver's side mirror arm and the metallic trim atop the steering wheel. That said, the R1T is, on the whole, very well sorted on tarmac. And yet, you can't really appreciate its charms until you venture off-road.
One of the first things that jumps out to you when driving the Rivian R1T, besides the absence of engine noise, is the solidity of the chassis. So when you go over bumps like this, the only sounds you really hear, you feel just a little bit coming from the suspension, but the chassis is so solid. Really, if you hear anything moving, it's stuff you brought with you. Another thing I've noted is that in the softer suspension setting, the ride quality off-road, even over the biggest of bumps, is really quite good. I do off-roading with my wife and kid, and I don't want my daughter flopping back and forth in her child seat, and this seems like a really great platform for driving with people and keeping them comfortable in the process. Excuse me while I tread lightly. Water crossing. I'm gonna point one other thing out that I really like about the Rivian. If you look at the steering wheel, as we go over bumps, it kind of goes back and forth. It's alive with action. See that right there? It's great because it reminds you that you're going over terrain. It's really satisfying to have an analog experience in what could be a very digital kind of vehicle. I'm on a hill here, and this is an opportunity to point out something interesting about the R1T. So there's a lot of dead space at the beginning of the travel of the accelerator. That's regen space. And so as long as you know that that's how the accelerator works, you can kind of promptly get to the point where you'll start getting pull. So if you're looking for really aggressive tipping, you won't find it here, but that's definitely by design. That also means that when you're coming down a hill, if you come off throttle, that regen means you don't have to use the brake pedal all that much. So you can almost one pedal drive this on pretty much any off-road situation. Last off-road observation, one of the things that gives you confidence when driving the R1T is that when you see the other R1Ts driving in front of you and you see that smooth belly, there's nothing hanging low to get caught up on rocks. You're not gonna drag a differential or a suspension piece. This is a pretty big rock. I might be concerned otherwise. Nope. Didn't drag nothing. In my experience, over gnarly trails, the R1T just goes. If there's traction to be found, the Rivian will find it and exploit it. Right now, if you're thinking this video is a little too complimentary, here are some points of consideration. One, the live camera view looks choppy at the moment, though I'm told an over-the-air update should fix it. Two, the R1T's tightly curated drive modes should work for most users, but finicky folks like me might appreciate more room to customize. Three, the R1T's 11,000-pound tow rating is impressive, but how many miles you can tow that weight remains to be seen. Also, charging up with a trailer attached could be a pain. Four, Rivian lacks a dealer network, instead relying on a mobile delivery and service approach. That could be a good thing, but right now the execution is unknown. And five, we have price. You'll need $67,500 to buy a base R1T Explorer package, not including destination charges. For perspective, the upcoming Ford F-150 Lightning electric truck will have a base price around $40,000. Tesla estimates a similar base price for their upcoming single-motor rear-wheel drive Cybertruck. And now, by mentioning Tesla, the comments section will devolve into an impotent firestorm of hot takes. Have at it. While there are cheaper ways to drive electric, the Rivian R1T offers a lot in base form. Standard features include vegan leather seats, heated up front, five drive modes, all-wheel drive because four motors, an in-bed air compressor with a 20-foot hose to reach each tire, a manual tonneau cover, a panoramic roof that, while well-tinted, might leave desert dwellers wishing for a sunshade, and Driver Plus, which is Rivian speak for their advanced driver assist system, featuring 11 cameras, 5 radar units, and 12 ultrasonic sensors. On the pricier $73,000 adventure package we're testing, you'll find ventilated front seats, an 18-speaker 1200-watt Meridian audio system that truly, undeniably bangs, and GearGuard, which utilizes a locking 8-foot cut-resistant tether system to keep your stuff yours. The two included tethers are supplemented by 360-degree video abilities to capture any nefarious behavior. I'll also add that the GearGuard screen animation is absolutely adorable. Helping mitigate the R1T's asking price are federal tax incentives to the tune of $7,500, plus state and local incentives depending on where you live. As for charging options, you can use a standard household outlet if you've got nowhere to be, or use a level 2 charger to gain 16 miles per hour charged. With your R1T, Rivian can also sell you a $500 wall charger that can add up to 25 miles of range per hour. And when covering distance, if you can find a 200 kilowatt DC quick charger, 20 minutes can add up to 140 miles of range. Oh, and bonus points to Rivian for the cool charger door. At the risk of further inflaming the comment section, I'll mention that Tesla's vast supercharger network is a ubiquitous and quick way to charge a car. I'll also say that America's non-Tesla charging infrastructure continues to expand. Based on my experience driving an Audi e-tron from coast to coast, that charger will probably be in the parking lot of a Walmart. By contrast, Rivian plans to add 20,000 chargers throughout the U.S., dubbed the Rivian Adventure Network, many of which will be strategically located at trailheads and other desirable outdoorsy spots. Besides the Cybertruck and F-150 Lightning, whenever they arrive, there really isn't a competitive set for the Rivian R1T. Yeah, you could buy a Honda Ridgeline or Jeep Gladiator for much less, but the R1T really is its own thing. You can't buy another truck this quick, the cabin is legitimately luxurious, and, for those who care, the R1T offers a responsible yet thrilling glimpse of our electrified future. Viewed strictly by the experience it provides, the Rivian R1T is extremely compelling. It's quick, it's rugged, it's capable, and it's filled with clever usability. Not only is it a new kind of pickup truck, it is an excellent pickup truck.